Given the quadratic function f of x equals 2x squared minus 11x minus 21, we want to find the x-intercepts, the y-intercept, the equation of the axis of symmetry, the vertex, and then graph the function. So for a quick review, the graph of a quadratic function produces a parabola, which we see here in blue. This green vertical line is the axis of symmetry, which has the equation x equals negative b divided by 2a. The vertex is the point on the axis and the parabola, so the x-coordinate will also be negative b over 2a, and the y-coordinate will be the function value when x equals negative b over 2a. The x-intercepts are where the graph crosses the x-axis. All points on the x-axis have a y-coordinate of 0, and the point where the graph crosses the y-axis is the y-intercept. Any point on the y-axis has an x-coordinate equal to 0. So let's go back to our function and find all of these components. Let's start by finding the x-intercepts. So we'll set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Remember, y values are function values, so to find the x-intercepts, we actually want to solve the equation 0 equals 2x squared minus 11x minus 21. Let's see if we can solve this by factoring. If this will factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors. The first terms must come from the factors of 2x squared, which would have to be 2x and x. The second terms must come from the factors of negative 21, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product would be negative 11x. So if we use the factors negative 7 and positive 3 for negative 21, we could put minus 7 here and plus 3 here. Notice how this would give us an outer product of negative 14x, an inner product of positive 3x, which does sum to negative 11x. Therefore, this does factor, and these are the correct factors for our quadratic. So this product is equal to 0 when 2x plus 3 equals 0, or when x minus 7 equals 0. So here we would subtract 3 and divide by 2. So one solution is x equals negative 3 halves. And here we have x equals positive 7. So our two x-intercepts listed as ordered pairs would be negative 3 halves, comma 0, and 7, comma 0. We could also say the x-intercepts equal. What we don't want to do, though, is give the x-intercepts as x equals negative 3 halves and x equals 7, because technically those would be equations of vertical lines. To find the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y, and remember y is the function value. So we can rewrite the function as y equals 2x squared minus 11x minus 21, replace x with 0, and notice how y is going to be equal to 0 minus 0 minus 21, or negative 21. When we have a quadratic function in this form, our constant c is always going to be the y-intercept. So our y-intercept has an x-coordinate of 0, a y-coordinate of negative 21, or we can say that the y-intercept equals negative 21. Again, we shouldn't just say y equals negative 21, because technically that would be a horizontal line. Now we also want to find the equation of the axis or axis of symmetry, and then the vertex. To do this, notice how we do want to identify the values of a and b based upon the form of the quadratic function. We should recognize that a is the coefficient of the x squared term, so that's positive 2. B is the coefficient of the x term, so that's negative 11. And we don't need it in this problem, but c would be equal to negative 21. So here's the formula for the equation of the axis. So we would have x equals negative negative 11 all over 2 times a, which is 2. So it looks like we're going to have positive 11 over 4. It's 11 fourths, which we can also express as 2 and 3 fourths. Or because we're going to plot this, it might be helpful to convert this to a decimal, which would be 2.75. So let's write the equation of the axis as x equals 2.75. And then to find the vertex, we know that the x-coordinate has to be 2.75 because the vertex is on the axis of symmetry, and then we need to find the function value when x equals 2.75. So we need to find f of 2.75, which is going to be 2 times 2.75 squared minus 11 times 2.75 minus 21. Let's go ahead and do this on the calculator. Here's the squared key. So the y-coordinate of the vertex is negative 36.125. If we did want this as a fraction, we can always press math, enter, enter. But since we are going to graph this, let's go ahead and use the decimal value. So the x-coordinate is 2.75, and the y-coordinate is negative 36.125. So let's go ahead and put all these pieces together and take a look at the graph. To save some time, I've already graphed this using graphing software, but notice how we have an x-intercept here of -3/2 or -1.5, as well as +7. We have a y-intercept of -21 here. The equation of the axis is x equals 11/4 or 2.75, which should be here, very close to +3, just to the left of +3. And lastly, notice our vertex is on the axis of symmetry, so the x-coordinate is 2.75, and the y-coordinate does look like it's -36.125. So this graph does verify that our work is correct. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.